native one of Ireland's first toll bridges. But the charge was so high that drivers refused to use it. Luckily, toll master Josephine Murphy came up with an ingenious plan to save the business. She started to pay them. You owe that guy £2, Josephine.
Still here in Waterford City, because this is where I'm going to meet our challenger this week, Brian Maher. Brian, how are you?
Fine, thanks.
You're very welcome to pay the price.
Thank you.
You're welcome. Okay, Brian, I hear you've got a very quirky challenge for us this week. Is that right?
That's right.
It's probably the most unusual we've had so far.
Oh, yeah.
Okay, Brian, well, I'm going to ask you all about that in just a second. But first of all about you, okay?
Okay.
Brian Maher was born in 1979. At an early age, he got into trouble with the law and ended up spending some time behind bars. Brian was arrested on lots of different charges: disturbing the peace, threatening Santa, and driving a tractor without a license. But Brian eventually gave up his life of crime and became a good boy. However, Dublin Zoo still want to talk to him about a missing tiger.
That was the life of Brian, and now to his challenge. Brian, your challenge.
Well, basically, we've got a couple waiting up in Red Square for two pizzas, but the pizzas are going to be delivered with a difference. There's going to be three lollipop people waiting down at the river there.
Okay.
To deliver the pizzas. One will use its stick to stop the traffic so the other two can get safely across the road. The other two will hold the pizzas on the sticks to deliver them up to Red Square. They will come up here, across the road, up through this street here, and up around the corner to Red Square where they will deliver them.
And how long do they have to do all of that?
90 seconds.
And can they do it?
I don't think so.
Okay, so we've got a bit of fast food with a difference then. We've got three lollipop women, we've got this stretch of road or path, and they've got to deliver them all within 90 seconds.
I don't think they can do it, because the lollipop sticks are fairly heavy, and with the speed they have to go with the long distance, they're going to have to balance them, and they can't drop them, so I don't think they're going to do it.
Okay, no way they can't do it. Before we find out whether they can do it or not, back to the river, to Simon, with the expert.
Okay, Rosie, thank you very much indeed. And here I am with our expert lollipop lady, Susan. Nice to see you, Susan.
Nice to see you, Simon.
Thank you very much indeed, Susan. Okay, in a moment, our exciting and fun challenge. But first, a few things that you didn't know about Susan.
As a young girl, Susan O'Connor had to share everything with her sister. Early on in life, she shared her pram. And when she grew up, she shared the settee. Susan got tired of sharing things, so she often hid away for a sneaky meal. Susan started work as a chemist assistant, but one thing she never took home from work was a bottle of fake tan. This was pointed out to her at a 1968 Tops of the Town, when someone told her the legs were white. So she headed off to Spain for a bit of sun. And when she got back, she was snatched up immediately. Susan has been a hit with the men ever since, and when she goes to a party, there's no stopping her.
Okay, folks, and here we go. This is going to be a fun one, I can tell you. This is Susan, our expert. You're all set to go, Susan?
Yes, Simon. Already.
You're very confident, aren't you?
Completely.
Okay, you've done a little bit of practice as well.
We have indeed.
And you have some help here. Who are these lovely ladies?
This is Liz.
Yes.
And this is Breeder.
Yes.
And they're very fit.
Yes.
And very fast.
And very fat?
Fast.
Oh, fast. All right then. Okay, you reckon, of course, you can do it, Susan. In 90 seconds, it's a tough
yes.
one. It's going
no.
to be a silly one as well. Over
no
here.
No problem.
No problem to you. Over here, somebody who thinks you can't do it. Come on in, Russia.
That's right. Simon, how are you, Susan? Nice to meet
Hello.
You. This
Hello.
Is your challenger, Brian. And we just had a little chat and we reckon you can't do it, Susan. Isn't that right, Brian?
That's right.
Brian is wrong. We can.
She's very confident, isn't she?
She's very
I think
confident.
She's going to do it. Something
I
tells
know,
me she's going to do it.
I don't think so.
Okay.
I don't think so.
Okay. Well, listen, don't forget, folks, somebody has to pay the price on the show today. What is pay the price? Well, to be honest, it's a little bit sad, Rush, isn't it? Because
I'm afraid so.
The connection here is flour. Pizzas are made of flour. What we're going to get you to do is dress up as a flour in the middle of the town. We're going to get the fire brigade to come along and give you a good soaking. So do you fancy that, Susan? Don't say yes.
No, no. Brian will get wet.
Do you reckon? Brian's
Brian,
the one's going to get wet?
Flour pie for you now?
No, I don't think so. You'll be doing going wet.
Oh, the heat is on, folks. All right, then. Susan, off you go and get set there with Liz and Breeder.
Okay, Simon.
Well, off you go. Good girl yourself. Fantastic.
Okay, see you guys. Okay, Brian, while they're on their way, I saw you having a little quick sprint up there yourself earlier on. How'd you fare?
Well, I don't think they can do it with the lollipop sticks and the pieces. They just won't get up there in time.
They won't get up there in time.
Okay, Rush,
okay,
I think, in fact, we're all set to go. Right, well, I'll give them the countdown of the old whistle.
Yeah,
okay, 3, 2, 1. she done? Yes, fantastic, Susan. What can we say? Oh, brilliant stuff. Let me in there. Well done. Congratulations
well
to you.
Done,
you're all out of breath.
Well done.
I'm out of breath as well myself. Well done, Liz. You lost a couple of pounds there. All right, Breeder. Well done. Fantastic. That was absolutely great. And with seconds to spare as well, you'll be pleased to hear.
I told you.
Because you're a fit woman. Jane Fonda, eat your heart out. All right, you know what that means,
Roger? Okay, Brian, more to the point, you know what this means, don't you?
Yes.
What do you have to do?
I have to dress up as a flower here and be hosed down by the fire brigade.
Yeah, you've got to pay the price. Okay, Brian, we've got your stuff ready for you right over there, okay? So get ready and we'll be over to you, okay?
Off you go.
See you in a second, Brian.
Right, you did it.
I told you, Simon.
And you had a few seconds to spare as well.
Well, fast and fit.
I'm telling you. Wonderful girls. Okay, where's the trophy? There we go. There we go. There's your pay the price trophy for you. I'm absolutely exhausted myself. Just looking at it. And I bought you something in the shops. There's a lollipop for you. Oh. And one for Liz. Hold on. And one for Rita. And one for Rosha as well.
Ah, Simon, you're too good. Thanks.
Thank you very much. And now I think we're going to have a look at him. Will we have a look at him?
We will.
Paying the price. Here he is, Brian, dressed as a flower, getting your watering.
Plain drops are falling on my head. They keep falling. I know the blues they send to greet me won't defeat me. And it won't be long till happiness walks up to greet me. Raindrops keep falling on my head, but that doesn't mean my eyes will soon be turning red. Crying's not for me, 'cause I'm never gonna stop the rain by complaining. I'm free. Nothing's worrying me.
Simon,
he got a drenching, didn't he?
Like absolutely.
Poor old Brian, the old flower. Well done, brilliant.
Okay, well, that was that challenge, and we're off to do our final challenge this week.
That's right. We're going to somewhere else now in Waterford. While we're on our way, have a look at this.
Waterford man Mikey O'Shaughnessy's wife was so annoyed with his pet dog that she insisted he give it the boot. Good man, Mikey. You certainly fooled her.
This week, both our challengers have lost, and it's